Okay, today we're going to do some field testing with the new Tesla Model 3. It's a long range, dual engine Tesla. And we're just going to have a short drive from the Netherlands to Belgium. Normally you use a key, but we connected it to the Tesla app using the iPhone. So the iPhone is the key from your car. Let's see.
Sla links af naar Dordtstraat. Sla links af naar Dieverstraat. Over 200 meter, houd rechts aan en neem ruime verdreef.
Because this car got a shorter wheelbase than the Model S, it drives more sporty. Well, there's not much in the car, it's just one screen, that's all. We got all the features that you need. And what if the screen breaks down? Well, you don't have anything anymore. This car is the new Tesla Model 3. The dual engine long range version. So now we are about to still have about 332 kilometers of power left. So we drive from Tilburg, the Netherlands, to Belgium, to Kontigem, a little bit further away than Antwerp.
Over 200 meter, sla rechts af naar Breda.
We just see what the consumption will be on the way back. Enjoy your ride.
Sla rechts af naar Bredasenweg.
In 9 minutes we will be arriving at another supercharge station, a station in Belgium, so let's see if they look the same as in the Netherlands.
Over 200 meter sla linksaf om op Mechelse Steenweg te blijven. Sla linksaf om op Kattenbroek te blijven. Sla linksaf. Straat.
Okay, it's time to start the Tesla. This Tesla Model 3, I start with using my iPhone. When I first got this Tesla, I got my iPhone connected to the system. And now, if the car is within a certain area of my iPhone, the doors will open and I can start the car and drive away. I don't need a key. I got a key at home and I always got my iPhone with me. Make sure that Bluetooth is on and make sure that there's enough power in the iPhone, because otherwise you won't drive away with the Tesla. Well, we put it here. We put it in the D from drive and we just go. Is this Tesla a great car? I think it is. I've driven lots of different electric cars, but none of them is so good as a Tesla regarding the drivability, the power and the range. Does the car got some issues? Well, it's very minimalistic, this. You only have an iPad screen and that's all you need. But I found something that's really interesting if you use the autopilot. It happened twice with me. I was driving on the highway, 120 kilometers an hour, passing a large truck, like a road train, a semi-trailer. This was a truck which was about 23 meters long, and we were in a three-lane highway. As soon as I passed the semi-trailer, there was another car passing me in lane 3 fast. And I'm not sure what happened, but the automatic pilot of the Tesla hit the brakes real hard. So slow down from 120 to about 70 k's in a second. But there was also a car behind me and he didn't like that. So he had to use his emergency brake to avoid a collision. I'm not sure why it happened, but it also happened later on with a smaller truck. And also at the same moment somebody wanted to pass me on lane 3. So if you're right in the middle of those two cars, I think the automatic system thinks there will be a collision, so it will hit the brakes. So still some fine tuning, but I'm sure the Tesla will work on it and fix it by the over-the-air software updates to this car. The consumption of this car is about 5 kilometers a kilowatt hour, and that's quite good. So the maximum range of this car is 575 kilometers if it's fully charged. But you never fully charge unless you make long road trips. Normally you put the settings on 80%. That's enough. So you have about 400 kilometers to drive. But I think if you drive this car 80 kilometers an hour and you don't use the airco and just put the mode on comfort, cruising speed on a long distance, 80 kilometers, it's easy to make, I think, about 625 kilometers. So that's quite good, and I think good enough for 99% of all the people who drive a car. But Tesla is about to introduce the Supercharge version 3, and with this new Supercharge option you can charge the car up to 250 kilowatt hours an hour. So that's twice the speed as the superchargers are doing today. So that will be a big advantage. Well, is this a good car to buy? I think it is. I think if you want to drive an electric vehicle, I think the Tesla Model 3 is the best car you can buy at this moment. It's smaller than the S and the X, but not that much smaller. So I think if you want this car, and you prefer longer distances, or you want to make holidays and go abroad, then I would go for the Model S. But this is a great car for a second car as well. If you got a Model S and a Model 3, I think the Model 3 will be used by the wife and the children. And the S, of course, for the man of the houses. So, I think it's good to buy this car because you got a long range. It's not that much more expensive than, for example, the Hyundai Kona or the Kia Niro. And if you compare it with the Audi e-tron, you have less distance that you can travel. Well, it's a premium brand, of course, Audi. But I think Tesla is more ahead regarding the drivetrain and the drivability of the car. Thanks for watching this episode of the Tesla Model 3, driven in the Netherlands in June 2019.